Hello everyone, and welcome back to Liftoff. If there is one thing that everyone is eager about, it is the first orbital test flight of the massive Starship rocket built by SpaceX. This is a one-of-a-kind rocket, and it is said to be the most powerful rocket in the industry. It'll also be the first launch of a fully reusable rocket. The rocket is said to be powerful enough that it will be used to ferry people to Mars and back, which is, according to SpaceX's CEO Elon Musk's lifelong mission of colonizing Mars. So far, the U.S. Federal Communications Commission, or the FCC, has already approved the launch, and the only remaining thing is for one of them to issue SpaceX with a license for launch. SpaceX still has to submit documents about the mission before being given the license. SpaceX recently submitted a document to the FCC that reveals something unheard of. According to the document, SpaceX is planning to perform the very first Starship booster catch attempt. Yeah, you heard that right. SpaceX will try and catch the Super Heavy booster in midair. But is this even possible? Let's find out. Before we proceed to find out more about this plan, make sure you hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for nothing but the latest updates on Elon Musk, SpaceX, science, space, technology, and so much more. And with that, let's find out what SpaceX really has planned. The document that SpaceX recently submitted to the FCC comes after another batch that was submitted in June 2021. This was when the company detailed its plans for Starship's orbital launch debut as background, as the company was requesting permission from the FCC to allow them to use the Starlink dishes for in-flight telemetry. A month before that, another request was made that focused more on standard telemetry antennas. It had already been revealed if the mission were successful, the Starship would not get into orbit on its first attempt. The request also indicated that SpaceX had no intention of recovering the upper stage or the Super Heavy booster assigned to Starship's launch debut. They submitted a new request for permission to use more of the Starlink dishes on both stages. Even though most parts of the document are similar to the one submitted last year, there are a few particular details that have changed, and they have now clearly indicated Super Heavy's role in this entire mission. According to this new document, SpaceX claims that the Super Heavy will separate, perform a partial return, and land in the Gulf of Mexico, or return to Starbase and be caught by the launch tower. Before this document was submitted, SpaceX's best-case plans for the very first launch of the Super Heavy booster were not far off from a controlled splashdown in the Gulf of Mexico. This demonstrated that it would be safe to attempt booster recovery on the next launch, guaranteeing that the first booster would be lost at sea. A year later, SpaceX now seems a bit too confident, and it wants to leave itself with only one option when it comes to recovering the first Super Heavy booster from launch. Now the company has dramatically complicated the entire process of testing the Super Heavy and Starship recovery, which are both bound to be reused. How have they complicated this? By doing away with the traditional and predictable landing legs. They have designed their latest prototype so that the only way that they will recover it in one piece is with a giant mechanized launch tower, which is popularly known as Mechazilla. The launch tower has three mobile arms that will play a crucial role in all aspects of orbital Starship launches. The first arm will be used to brace the Super Heavy Starship as it is installed and connected to the power, propellant supplies, and other launch pad facilities. There is a more complicated pair of arms dubbed chopsticks that performs a more complex operation. In addition to using the chopsticks to lift, stack, and move the Starship and Super Heavy booster during any weather and wind conditions, SpaceX wants to utilize these arms as a rocket recovery system. This is a very complicated and very dangerous process. For this to happen, the booster or the Starship will have to approach the tower, enter the gap between the arms, which will obviously be spread out, hover in place as the arms close around it, and eventually come to rest on hardpoints that appear to offer about as much surface area as a coffee table. Elon Musk showed a simulation of the entire process, and from the simulation, this is more than a catch. This is especially difficult because the arms will only move in one dimension, which is opening or closing, and they cannot actually grab the rocket in any real sense. According to how they are built and shown, they are closer to a tiny fixed landing platform that seems to be vulnerable to some minor last-minute positional adjustments. Eventually, the chopsticks could manage to shed a small amount of time that would be used in post-recovery processing, thus eliminating the need for a crane or the same arms to help attach them to the landing booster or ship. In addition to that, they could manage to get rid of the dry mass that comes with the installation of the landing legs. However, they cannot do this completely because the interplanetary ships will still need these legs. After all, the planets are not fitted with such a mechanism. However, this makes their job of proving their own effectiveness and success a complete nightmare. This is because this is one of the most dangerous operations to indulge in, especially for something as massive as the Starship. By all appearances, the current recovery mechanism on the arms and the landing hardpoints on shops and boosters indicate that a catch can fail if either of the stages is more than a foot or two from a perfect bullseye. Not only that, but the catch would also fail if the stages were to rotate just a few degrees in the wrong direction. The system that SpaceX has devised for this means that even the slightest error could be catastrophic. It could result in a massive, pressurized, partially fueled rocket destroying the chopsticks and dropping down a few hundred feet to the ground. This could easily mean an explosion that could end up damaging the surrounding infrastructure or even starting fires that could lead to the same. In the event that a larger anomaly occurs during the entire process of landing, a Starship or Super Heavy could impact the launch tower unwillingly. This would end up damaging or maybe even destroying the skyscraper-sized structure. Ultimately, there is a high risk with the catch attempt. The company must be very cautious as they expand many of these ships and boosters to avoid rendering the only Starship launch tower unusable. This is unless they make sure that they design everything involved in the process perfectly and do all the calculations correctly. There can be no room for error, or else there would only be counting losses. To some extent, SpaceX has taken all this into consideration, and they know that the Super Heavy would need to be in excellent health. It would have to perform flawlessly during the ascent and boost pack portions of its launch debut to be cleared for the risky catch attempt. If they were to get everything right, Starship's first orbital launch could end up being one of the greatest achievements in the history of spaceflight and rocket launches. As to when we'll be seeing the launch of the massive Starship and Super Heavy booster, it's still unclear. Not so long ago, there was an accumulation of gas beneath the Super Heavy Booster 7 prototype, leading to an unexpected explosion during ground tests. However, according to Elon Musk, the damage is minor. He said that the booster might have to be taken to the high bay for inspections, which might set them back a couple of weeks. Musk was hoping to launch the fully stacked Starship this month, but it doesn't seem like it will happen. It might not even happen for the next couple of months. It is clear that SpaceX is ambitious. But if there is one thing we know for sure, it is that nothing is impossible for any company led by Elon Musk. What they have achieved is unlike any other, and they're still destined for more greatness. Do you think that SpaceX will actually succeed with this catch attempt on the Super Heavy booster? Feel free to let us know in the comment section below. Also, before you go, make sure you smash that like button and subscribe to our channel for nothing but the latest updates on Elon Musk, SpaceX, Tesla, science, space, technology, and so much more. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.